I'm Sean Carruthers, and welcome to How Do I on BetterScotch.com. In this series, we're taking a look at the Roku player. In this episode specifically, we're going to talk about the settings menu. Now, when you fire up the Roku player, typically it'll launch you on the screen where it says Channel Store. But if you go over to the left, you'll actually see one that says Settings. Now, this is where you can start tweaking some of the settings of your Roku player or reset things up that don't work quite right. So you're going to click the OK button on your remote to go through into the settings menu, and you'll see some of the options pop up here. First up, we have the network setting. We'll click through there. And we'll see a brief overview of the way the player is currently connected to the network. If we want to change this, we can repeat the guided setup, and that'll take you to the same thing that we saw when we first set up the player for the first time, and that will be to select wireless or wired and then set up your network. We're going to hit back, and we're going to hit back again. Over to the next one is the display type, and again, this is the one that you may have seen when you first set up your player. This allows you to change between the different types of TV. So if you have a 4x3 or 16x9 old school television with a lower resolution, you can change it to this, or you can drop down to 720p resolution or up to 1080p resolution. Once we've selected the one that we want, we're going to hit select, and then we're done. Scrolling over to audio mode, clicking through, we have the option to stay with stereo, which is basic stereo, or if we have a surround system that we're plugging in through the optical connector, we can click to that as well, and that'll switch us into 5.1 surround sound mode. We're actually going to go back in and change it to stereo because we don't have surround speakers set up. Over on the next screen, we have sound effects, and that adjusts the volume of the sound effects that we have when we go through the menu system. So if we want high, we can change it to high, we can choose medium, low, or if we don't want to hear them at all, because we don't like beeping all the time, we can switch it right to off. We're going to leave it on medium. On the next screen, we have the screensaver options. By default, you'll see the bouncing Roku logo, and we can preview it like so. It'll just put the Roku logo on the screen and then move it around the screen every so often. We have the ability to change that up top, so we'll click on this button, and it'll switch us over to a new option, in this case, the Roku analog clock, or we can change it to a Roku digital clock. With some of these, we have some custom settings options that we can click through and get to and select the style, LCD, Larrabee, old typewriter, for example. So you can customize that a little bit. We're going to go back up to change screensaver. We're going to go back to the bouncing Roku logo. We also have the ability to change the wait time, which is the amount of time the Roku will sit there idle before it starts to go into screensaver mode. So by default, we have 10 minutes, 30 minutes. We can disable it completely if we want, or we can go down to 5 minutes. We're going to go back up to 10 minutes, which gives us a number of minutes before it actually kicks in automatically. Sometimes we're just sitting there not looking at something, but we don't want it to necessarily kick into screensaver mode instantly. Then we'll click Done when we're done selecting those options. Next option is time setting. Again, this is some of the stuff we saw during initial setup. We have the ability to change the home screen clock between 12 and 24 hour mode. We can turn it off completely if we want. We can change the time zone from here as well, so if we are in a different time zone, we can switch it over to that. So we have all of the ones that are available in North America on this particular model here. Then when we're done, we're going to go down and click Done. Next option here is for Netflix. So if you have the Netflix premium channel set up, you can actually set it up here with some extra settings. So we can deactivate this player completely from a Netflix account, or we can disable browse and search in Netflix if you want to do that. We'll go down and click Done. Now the next option here is player info, and when we click through, we can actually see what the software is, including the build number of the software we're using right here to run the Roku player. We also see the hardware version. We also see a bit of networking information, including MAC addresses. We'll see the serial number for the unit itself, and we'll see the Roku account that this player is currently linked to. We can use the button at the bottom that says check for update, and it'll go out onto the network to see if there are any new updates available for this software. And if there are, it'll tell us here and give us the option to launch it and install it. In this case, we don't have any available at this time, so we'll click OK. Then we'll click Done. And the last option here is factory reset. So if you want to wipe out everything that's on this player right now, I mean, there's no storage on here, but you can wipe out the settings and go back to a complete, pristine state that you got when you got it from the factory, then you can go and do that here. So we'll click through. Now, one of the reasons you may want to do that is you're giving the unit away, and you don't want them messing with your settings on this device, so they can set it up the way they want, or for example, if there's something wrong with it that you think maybe resetting it to factory settings will help, you can go through that here. Just a reminder that it will save your settings on the Roku.com site, all of the channels that you have, but it'll change all of your settings from a hardware perspective by doing this. So we're going to hit factory reset here because we want to set this up again. It'll give us a caution here to make sure we absolutely want to do this. If we don't, we can hit no, but we're going to hit yes, because we actually want to reset it at this point. Then it'll wipe the device clean to take us through a factory reset back to the state it was when we first took it out of the box. That's it for settings menu on the Roku player. Don't forget to check out the other parts in this series where we show you other ways of interacting with the player. And don't forget to check out the show notes for this and the other parts of the series at butterscotch.com.